This is episode 27 on Teck Resources. Teck. Oh my God, this is a manufacturer of zinc, copper, one of the biggest players in North America. One of the most cyclical stocks, but it's the most valued companies in the world. To the party bus. Vegas living. They fucked up right now. That's how we do it.
I will break my
leg. It's a better
life when you throw her.
We're gonna take it 2020. Circa 2020. Street. Hello guys, this episode is about Teck Resources. I'm finally back from Las Vegas. I hope you enjoyed that little clip I had of me living Sin City style. As some of you that know me, you know I work hard and I play even harder. Did I say harder or harder? I play even harder. This episode is about Teck Resources. If you don't know Teck Resources, I am completely stunned that you've made it this far in life. No, I'm just kidding. Teck Resources is a diversified metal and mining company. They have four distinct business units. Copper is their one of the top ones, which comprises 37% of their revenue base. Then followed by zinc, metallurgical coal. They're the second largest metallurgical coal exporter. They're one of the largest zinc producers, with the largest mine in Alaska, Red Dog Mine, as well as they have a total of 10 mines, and then they have several mines in Chile and Peru, so most of their copper production is in South America and some in Canada, close to Vancouver. They have energy fields in Alberta, Canada. So they're very well diversified. It's a company that has a strong management. They were voted one of the top places to work in Canada 4 years in a row. Top 100 employers, top 50 places to work for young people, and equality of sexes. What I love about Teck's management is that they keep a very strict, vigilant eye on their balance sheet. So they pay down debt as much as they can. Last year, they returned $207 million to their shareholders by buybacks. They pay 0.74% dividend yield, which is not a lot, but it's a stock that shows a lot of capital appreciation. So the stock rises in tandem, they're having a dividend. So some of you dividend investors know that you cannot have both. If a company pays a very strong dividend, then they don't have a lot of capital price appreciation because of the DuPont formula. So there's a stock that there's a company that did $8.9 billion in revenue last year, ended the year with $500 million in EBITDA. And one major downside of Teck is it's a cyclical company. So the reason it doubled in the last year, went from $11 to $22 a share, is because the copper prices also doubled. As a matter of fact, copper prices are through the roof. We have supply constraints because of COVID, and then we have a strong demand. And with Joe Biden planning to spend a lot of money on infrastructure and rebuilding of our bridges and so forth, analysts expect the copper prices to rise even higher the rest of 2021. So copper prices haven't been at $4 a pound since year 2011. And this is a double-edged sword for Teck, because when copper prices are high, Teck benefits and the stock makes new highs. And it's been bouncing off of $18 a share. Another thing I wanted to tell you is a major downside lately has been that it's a Canadian company. It's based out of Vancouver, Canada, so it has, the Canadian dollar has been very weak. At one point, in 2020 or 2019, Canadian dollar was 70 cents to a US dollar. Right now, it has gone up a lot, so right now it's 80 cents to a US dollar. So if you gotta visit Canada, you should do it now before it becomes 90 cents to a dollar. So those are the two major components that keeps Teck very cyclical and very volatile. But it's a very strong company. It has strong cash position. Last year, I think they had $6.5 billion in liquidity. And they had, I think, about $1 billion of it in cash. So being one of the largest zinc producers, second largest metallurgical coal exporter, and as you know, metallurgical coal is way more valuable than regular coal. And also they have, they also produce very minor amount of other metals, such as lead, silver, and even molybdenum. Did you guys know what molybdenum is? I just found that out. Molybdenum, am I saying it right? I think so, it's molybdenum. It's a metal that has a very high melting point and doesn't rust. And it's used in stainless steel and other products. So 85-86% of it is used in construction. And even your body produces molybdenum, which I didn't know. So check it out. Teck is a good portfolio stock, and it's a good stock that I trade on a regular basis. I've even written an article about it back in 2017 entitled, and you can Google this, entitled Teck Resources, an option play can double your money. And this is an article on Seeking Alpha. So keep this stock in your portfolio and trade it, and keep a strict watch on copper prices, zinc prices, as well as metallurgical coal. Yeah, and it's starting to become a very notable energy producer as well because of their Alberta fields. All right, guys, that's about it. This is short and sweet, episode 27. If you have any questions or concerns, drop a comment, subscribe, and click that notifications button. And soon I will figure out how to use a software where I can do these cool animations while I'm talking, and maybe we can show the chart while I'm talking and all that. But for now, let's just keep it going. One thing, Recently, I lost 2 subscribers. We went from 59 down to 57. 59 down to 56, and then I gained a new subscriber, so we came back to 57. So I'm getting a little bit of a churn rate, which I like. Okay, and I'm really excited, and I cannot wait until we hit 100 subscribers and see the rate of change from 100 subscribers to 1,000 subscribers, as I'm planning to take over this YouTube game as well.